ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم وأعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله إن خير الهادي هادي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the world, who is the master of the day of judgment, and salatu salam to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is the best of mankind. Salaam alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, thank you for giving me time, brother. Ali bhai said you give the just a small talk. I didn't prepare just few minutes before. First of all, I like to give it a bit briefly about the talk about the Dawa. What is Dawa and why it is important in Islam? I like to give example when you wanted to clean your own clothes. What you need? Nice detergent or nice soap, something like that. There is two types of heart. One is my heart, one is your heart. I know how to clean my heart if I read it in Quran, Zikr, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but how can I clean the other people's heart? In this world at the moment, we need to think about our hearts and including the other people's hearts also, how to clean. Because of there is so much blackness in the other people's heart that we need to clean. That is only the way to clean other people's heart by the Dawah. To invite to the people towards the Tawheed, towards the oneness of Allah, towards the Islam. That is the goal setting we must need to do it by all the individual of the Muslim Ummah. Muslim Ummah suffering around the world because of lack of knowledge, lack of practice in their own deen. They mind their own prayer, and because of the busyness of this dunya, they forgetting the Akhirah. And subhanAllah, we need to prepare to how to give dawa and what to say. It is just the conversation we need to do. Little bit effort to the every people, whoever contact with us, whoever we have chance to talk with them, or whoever we have a dealing with any business daily, you know, you meet your colleague, whoever, your boss or whoever, whatever, those people who are not in Islam, you are contacting with them, you're talking with them. That is very important to start the conversation with the polite manners, humbleness, truthfulness. Politeness is very important, and we need to see the guidance of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he started talking, dealing with all the surrounding people. And this is one man mission. Islam is one man mission. Because of the truthfulness, even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was a ummi. He doesn't know how to write and read, but because of the truthfulness, because of the wahi, the sahih wahi, the truth of Islam, and now around the world 2 billion people follow him and ready to die for him in his name. In for the Islam, for the Quran, that is the love. The most beloved person of this earth is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May peace and blessing him and his ummah, who is follow the rightly towards the right guidance. Like I was saying, that what we need to clean our clothes, detergent. When we put the clothes in the bucket and the detergent, soap, whatever, it will not clean itself. We need to do the washing. Nowadays, even nobody do the with hand. Washing machine is there, but still, if you put detergent and the soap and softener in the washing machine and the clothes, it's still not going to wash unless you touch the button. Button is the Dawa, starting point. Starting point, you need to do according to the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whatever the knowledge, small knowledge you have, whatever the sheikh you are, doesn't matter. In Islam, one ayat is enough to spread the message of Islam, and Allah will judge, Allah will care for that person, and Allah will give the hidayah that person. It is not in our hand. Our duty is to give the message rightly, the nicely. Rest is, it is Allah who will give the hidayah to the home He wills, and whoever Allah will guide them, just need the click, like the button. And what you have the knowledge, you need to pass to the other person, wherever you are, whatever the situation, and just always find the opportunity to give the knowledge of Islam to the non-believer is called Dawa. Dawa is invitation. Means when somebody invite to the food and the wedding, we so much happy to go there. But if you invite to the person towards the Islam, and because of the lack of knowledge, he doesn't know about Islam, only negative things. Muslim are the terrorists. Muslim are the bad guys. They are letterbox, whatever they say. We are those people who are always, they brush all the ummah as a bad guy, bad person. And that is not truth. Allahu Akbar, it is the true deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can feel when I came to the Islam, I know from that moment when I come to the Islam, and subhanAllah, that confidence that Islam is truth. That confidence that you are, if you are truthful, truly Islam, the following and the true Muslim, you cannot sleep in peace unless you giving Dawah, thinking about the Ummah, how to protect this Ummah, and giving the knowledge of Islam to the non-believer who are chasing after the Muslim people to kill them, crush them, but truth will prevail. It is Allah's command. Allah will protect this deen until the day of judgment. You don't need to fear anybody. When you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't need to worry anything in this world. This world is passing by. We came in this world, we born in this world, we are alive, but next year we are going to die. And we born to die. And this is the truth, and this is the fact. If we came in this world to die, so why not do the good deeds, righteous deed? What is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Even if you smiling too nicely into the non-believer, saying salam to the people, it is the good deeds. Whatever you have, and the good deeds is very high value in the akhirah. If you believe there is the life after that, then you need to wake up. Wake up in the fajr, pray, come to the mosque, regularly tilawa, read the Quran, and search for the opportunity, talk to the other in the right manners, smile to the other. And this is the ummah we are facing because of the lack of laziness. We are so comfortable in our bed, we need to think how to comfort our grave after the death. We need to think about the akhirah more than this world. This world is just the pass by. Hereafter is everlasting life. So we need to think more than this life, because hereafter is more never finished. And may Allah protect us from the any harm to us in this world and hereafter. And may, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us according to our deeds, according to our knowledge, according to our effort, according to our ability. And Allah will never give us the burden more than we can bear in our shoulder. So my respected brother and sister, I request you, all of you, and we are facing in very difficult time around the world, and only the solution and cure is to clean the other people's heart, to clean the other people total from the total black heart, to bring the right sound heart need effort, and need effort daily, slowly, whatever you can, to clean all the heart purely. For sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are doing the job. For sake of Allah, not to recognize by any people or anything. So to know by Allah that you are doing the job and you are trying to do your best. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I give you the telephone, you will remember until the telephone with you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the eyes, the power of eyes, I can see the whole world. Power of hearing, I can hear the news from the around the world. And we can taste the food from the around the world. Subhanallah. But we never thank him as much as he deserves. And we cannot stand, we cannot wake up in the morning because of the cold weather. Think, who is Allah first? Who give us the life? Who will give us the death? And death is sure, but we don't know when it's coming. Death is sure. It will come to us one by one or according to by his plan. And before we die, before too late, wake up, come to the mosque, think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you think deeply that Allah give me the life, when you wake up, Alhamdulillah, I'm still alive, then go, wake up. Come to the mosque, whichever the mosque nearby you. Increase your iman. And first of all, clean your heart. Do the wudu. Think that you need to do something nice before you die. Something good deeds you need to earn. We did many mistakes. We did many sins. We need to do the istighfar, tawbah. Oh Allah, forgive us whatever we done. Now, from now on, we need to do the good deeds. Because we are lack in good deeds. We have so much bad manners, bad thinking, bad habit. Give up all the bad habit and do the good deeds. In every day, slowly, if you have the bad habit, give up slowly. Do the righteous deeds. That is only you can clean your own heart and give the good guidance or good Islamic knowledge to the other people. That will clean their heart. That misconception about Islam around the world, all the leaders of the world who have power, they have brainwashed by the media, brainwashed by the misconception of Islam. We need to think about that deeply. And subhanallah, one person can do job. We don't need many people to do the job. One person at a time, one people at a time. Slowly but firmly. When you believe firmly that your faith is truth, when you believe that you are true Muslim, when you believe that Allah chosen you to become a Muslim, either by birth or by the reverted or converted, it is there the purpose that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to give you the reward in the Akhirah. Because this world is passing by. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, your life is like a bird. When you wake up in the morning, you are flying, you don't know what is your earning, and when you come in the late evening, your stomach is full. Think about that. Think about that. We are like a bird. Whatever the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the responsibility and ability, use it for sake of Allah to spread the message of Islam. Give dawa to the non-Muslim. And call the other Muslim brother towards the Islam. Give them knowledge of iman and knowledge of tawheed. Who give us the beautiful life. We are comfortably living in the Western countries. And there is so much freedom for us. But people are dying hunger. And we need to unite. Our Ummah is so much weak. Every mosque has differences, but doesn't matter. We are one Ummah. We need to united Ummah. We need to become a united Ummah. So no one can break us. No one can break us. That is from internal. We need to fight internal jihad. Internal jihad, correct ourselves. We have mistake upon our our heart, that we think about that person is doing, that person doing wrong and wrong. But first of all, we need to think what we are doing. What we are doing every day, daily basis, give up misguidance towards watching something bad. So give up all the bad habit, correct ourselves first, inshallah. May Allah protect this Ummah and unite all of us in the one umbrella that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Haqq. Haqq is truth, Islam is truth, Quran is one, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam one, Tawheed is one. So oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to think about deeply how He gives us the power, ability to all the power what we are doing. And this speech, this mouth is made to give the Dawa. And this body to worship Him alone. Other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not going to create any creation. Allah knows why He created, why He made us the Muslim. We need to think deeply. He made us the Muslim, not the need to be a brave in every field, wherever you are. Whatever you do, you need to be a very brave, and you are the fighter of the, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, protect this deen. And if I do any mistake, this is from myself. If I say any something good, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallahu khair for my your time you giving me to speak in this mosque. Jazakallahu khair. As-salatu as-salamu ala Rasulullah. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallahu khair.
He's not coming.
You haven't told
them to come now. Sheikh is still not here, so I like to give something about the Dawa also. I just like to read. Maybe inshallah you'll be here very soon. Every human is a slave. You are either a slave of your desire or a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You either live life by your rules or the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can the heart travel to God if it is chanting by its desire? O son of Adam, sell this world for the hereafter and you win both. If you sell the hereafter for this world, you lose both. Deen over dunya. Islam is not a buffet where you pick and choose what suits you. Don't obey your desire, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imprisoned is he whose heart is imprisoned by from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Captured is he who is captured by his desire. Fudail ibn Iyad asked, what do you find the stranger of all things? He said, the heart that knows Allah, yet still disobey him. Don't miss Salah for the sake of people. You were born and will die alone. You will go to the grave alone, be questioned alone on the day of judgment. Close friend, on the day they will be not give you any help. Neither enemy can harm you. You will be alone. Fajr you are asleep, Dhuhr you are busy, Asr you are tired, Maghrib you are watching TV. Isha you are eating, you can do prayer, but not death. We pray for uncertain matter in our life, like marriage, etc. But we prepare for the one event that is definitely going to happen. Death, the first things a slave will be held to account for his salah. If we fall short on that day, then we will fall short on that to come. Fajr, please don't fear missing sleep. Fear a day on which there will be no sleep. You cannot sleep on the, after the day of judgment. There will be never sleep. Expecting paradise while neglecting prayer, it is not a joke. Prayer is not a joke. It is obligatory and obligatory upon all of us. It's like waiting for a train to arrive at the airport. Remember the prayer, Dua. Everyone dreams to be in the Jannah, but Allah says paradise is not obtained by your wishful thinking. Like if you are not praying and waiting for the Jannah that you will go, that you are waiting the train, you are in the airport, is never going to happen. So prayer is the very important part of our life. Prayer gives you peace in your heart. If you could hear the sound of the pens of angels writing your name among those who remember Allah, you will die out of joy. How much important that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, the mention by the angels mention about the person's name, so and so is praying, so and so is reading Quran, so and so is reciting the Quran. It is very important. This dunya is not a resting place, it is a testing place. Here we didn't come for the rest, this is for the test. Resting place for the non-believer, they can rest, they can enjoy, they can go to the club and pub and whatever they like. But our duty is to never tire. Work for your deen, work for your family, work for yourself, but work hard to increase your iman, spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you can. He whom Allah has predestined to enter paradise, the region which he caused his entrance shall spring from calamity. He whom Allah has predestined to enter the hellfire, the region which will cause his entrance shall spring from lust. Get used a rough life, for a luxury does not last forever. Umar ibn al-Khattab, do not be overly pleased by easy times. Verily, gold is tested by its purity by fire. Likewise, righteous servant is tested by tribulation and pain. So we need to think about that. When we have the faith, we face many difficulty, and Allah will go through those difficulty and make your difficulty come easy. So the life is difficult, full of difficulty. All the prophet used to face. You know the prophet Moses alayhi salam, when the Pharaoh, he came out from his palace, he walked many days in the desert. He went after a long time. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. He asked the dua, O Allah, bless me. Ask dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing if you are in any difficulty. And the human beings are in difficult, especially Muslim Ummah is to face the difficult. And Allah will judge according to how much facing the difficult. And Allah will give us the easy in this life and the hereafter. Inshallah. May Allah protect us and give us the easy life in this world and hereafter. So this life is short, but hereafter is everlasting life. So Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhabannar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our both life easy and successful. JazakAllah khair.